गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज आवर सेकंड प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ सेमिस्टर सेकंड. द एम ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल इज लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ साइकस. एक्चुअली इट इज द फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल एंड फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल हैविंग टू लाइफ साइकिल. फर्स्ट वन इज द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ नेफ्रोलिपिस एंड सेकंड वन इज द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ साइकस. ओके, एक्चुअली दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल फर्स्ट. हियर लेट अस सी, स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द सिस्टमैटिक पोजिशन. Division is the psychodophyta. The characteristic of this psychodophyta is seeds are exposed. Pollination by wind. Fertilization is siphonogamous. Stem generally unbranched. Leaves large, pinnately compound. Sperms are motile. This cycas is actually gymnospermic plant. And what is meant by gymnosperm? Gymnos means naked and sperma means seed. So, in the first character, seeds are exposed. That means the seeds are open. That is the main important character of the psychodophyta. Okay. Second one is the order. Cycadels. Presence of male cone while female sporophyll are separate. Wood is soft and monoxylic. Okay. This is the character of the cycadels. Family. Cycadaceae. What is the character of Cycadaceae? First one is the stem is unbranched. Okay, the plant is coconut tree like structure. Okay, we are also seen in the figure. Let us see here. This is the structure. Only one stem is present. Okay, stem unbranched, no branches is there. Leaves large and pinnately compound, forming the crown on the apex of the stem. Let us see in this figure. Crown. Crown-like structure is present at the apex. Next one is the leaf with the single mid-vein. Veinlets are absent and ovules are the orthotopous. This is the characteristic of Cycadaceae. And genus is Cycas. There are the different species are there like Cycas, ovulata, etc., etc. Let us see. External. Let us see the externally how that sporophyte or plant look like externally. Externally, the plant body is differentiated into the aerial stem, thick and stout taproot and leaves, and it resembles the palm tree in having unbranched stem and crown of the large leaves, like palm-like structure it having. Okay, externally. Root. Cycas has a normal taproot system which is the short-lived. Later it is replaced by the adventitious root. Okay, primarily it is the taproot and further it is the adventitious root. The adventitious root develops some negatively geotropic lateral. That means the root grows in upward direction. So they are known as the negatively geotropic. Okay, they are comes out of the soil in some cases. So they are known as the negatively geotropic. When they are go in deeper into the soil, it is positively geotropic, and when it comes out of the soil, it is known as the negatively geotropic. These lateral come out of the soil surface and divide dichotomously, forming branch of the roots, and these branches are called as the coralloid root. The coralloid root are coral like and greenish in color. The coralloid root contain the symbiotic bacterial like the Pseudomonas azotobacter along with the some blue green algae like the Anabina and Nostocal. So there is a close relation with them. In this way, this is about the root. Stem, as we see it in the figure, the stem, it is the single unbranched stem is there. The stem is generally unbranched and grow 3 to 4 meters in height. The stem is covered with the by the wood bases of the fallen leaves like the coconut only. The main stem is cylindrical and thick. It is woody and surface is tough. In female cycas, the stem is monopodium. That means the single axis and unbranched. In male cycas, the stem is with the single axis, but it has many lateral branches fuses together assuming the vertical position called as the sympodial or false branching. There is the branching, but that branching is the false branching is present in the male cycas plant. In this way, this is about the stem, and last one the leaves. Cycas leaves are the dimorphic, that means there are two type of leaves in cycas: green foliage leaves and brown scaly leaves. Brown and small scaly leaves are there. Let us see. This is the structure of leaf. These are the green leaf. The foliage leaves are the long, spirally arranged on the tree trunk. The leaves forming the crown at the apex of the stem. The foliage leaves is pinnately compound. Let us see in the figure. Pinnately compound leaf are there. The young leaves shows the sarcinate tissics, and the foliage leaves consist of the persistent leaf base. Rachis and number of sessile leaflet are also present. The leaflet on the lower side of the rachis are modified to form the spines. Each leaflet is strong, leathery, sessile, lanceolate, linear, and has a spiny apex. There is a single vein at the center, while secondary veins are absent. The scale leaves are tangular, dry, and brownish in color. The scale leaves are alternate with the foliage leaves. Okay, in this way, this is the foliage leaves. Anatomy: when we take the section of a leaf, okay, a TS of leaf, when they are younger, when we take a section, the pinny of the cycas is dorsiventral. The section shows the center bulged portion with represent the central midrib. Okay, let us see here. This is the bulged portion at the lower side, and it shows the central bulged portion which represent the central midrib, upper and lower epidermis and mesophyll tissue. Upper epidermis is single layer, okay, thick walled, compactly arranged layer of cell with their outer wall heavily cutinized. Okay, the when we see the structure of the leaf, we know that it is somewhat thicker and cutinized. The stomata are absent in this plant. Hypodermis, below the epidermis is present a single or two layered thick wall sclerenchymatous hypodermis. Mesophyll, beneath the mesophyll layer consists of the spongy parenchyma and palisade layer. Below the hypodermis, the palisade layer having thin walled, compactly arranged and chlorenchymatous elongated layer of the cell is there. The spongy parenchyma consists of thin walled, loosely arranged, irregular shape chlorenchymatous layer of the cell. Okay, that means beneath the hypodermis, this is the mesophyll cell is present. Let us see in this structure. Upper epidermis, okay, beneath that hypodermis, and beneath that the mesophyll cell. They again divided into the palisade tissue and spongy mesophyll cell. Let us see in this figure. Palisade tissue, they are somewhat elongated, and spongy mesophyll cell, they are circular in nature. They are having both upper epidermis and lower epidermis is present here. Stomata is also present here. Vascular bundle at the center. Let us see in the diagram. At the center, the vascular bundle is present. There is a single centrally located vascular bundle. It is made up of the xylem toward the upper epidermis, and it is triangular in shape. Okay, the broader part is at the upper epidermis, and it is made up of the metaxylem. Okay, the larger xylem is known as the metaxylem, while pointing toward the epidermis, it is made up of the protoxylem. It is the smaller xylem is known as the protoxylem. The phloem is situated toward the lower epidermis and made up of the sieve cell only. Okay, at the lower part, there is a presence of the phloem cells. There is non-functional cambium is present in between the xylem and phloem, and the xylem and phloem is surrounded by the bundle sheath cell. Okay, let us see in the figure. It is surrounded by the bundle sheath cell, and that xylem, it is toward the upper epidermis, and at the lower epidermis, near the lower epidermis or the side of lower epidermis, phloem is present. After that, the lower epidermis, it consists of the thick wall, barrel shaped single layer of the cell. It having the sunken stomata with deep stomatal cavity is present at the lower epidermal cell. In this way, this is when we take the section TS of the leaf, these all part are seen there. Next one, the reproductive structure in the cycas. Cycas is dioecious plant producing the reproductive organ on the separate plant. That means the spore are formed on the sporophyll. That means the male sporophyll are grouped together in the male cone while female cone are free. Okay, there are the two separate plant, male plant and female plant, they are separate. Let us see in this figure. Here at the left side the male cone is there, and at right side the female cone, megasporophyll are there. Okay, in the left side microsporophyll and in right side the megasporophyll are there. Let us see what are they. First one is the megasporophyll. The male cone is produced at the tip of the branches. Okay, let us see in the diagram. It is large, cylindrical, tapering at the both end and dark brown in color. The surface shows the rhomboidal area each with triangular structure in the center. The male cone is made up of the central axis which is elongated and cylindrical. The central axis bears many flat leaf-like structures called as the microsporophyll around them. Okay, the microsporophyll is spirally arranged over the central axis, and each microsporophyll is flat and bordered at the one end and narrow at the other. Broader at the one end and narrower at the other end. The broader end is thick and bears pointing outgrowth called as the apophysis. Okay, the lower surface is microsporophyll, bears many globular structure called as the sori, and each sori is the made up of 2 to 6 small sessile oval small hollow structure called as the pollen sacs. It is also known as the microsporangium. Each microsporangium contains the numerous pollen grains in them. Each pollen grain is microscopic, spherical, unicellular, uninucleated, with central exine wall and inner outer exine wall and inner intine wall. In this way, this is the structure of the microsporophyll. Next one is the female cone. Let us see the structure. Female cone. The female plant does not bear the cone as such, but the whole of the separate leaf-like structure are produced called as the megasporophyll or carpel. They are produced alternate with the foliage leaves at the tip of the stem. This megasporophyll, each megasporophyll are 6 to 12 inch long. They are 6 to 12 inch long. It is flat, thick and remains covered with the brown woolly scales, and the axis is pinnately notched at the lower part, and it bears 2 to 5 naked ohul in the notch. Okay, in this way, this is the structure of the female cone. Let us see the structure of ohul. When we see in the megasporophyll, there is a ohul. Each ohul of the cycle is oval. Cycas is oval, dark green, orthotropous, that means micropylar. Let us see in the diagram. Micropyle is the upper region. Okay, and endosperm, it is at the centrally located. Okay, and when micropylar opening is at the in the topmost part, it is known as the orthotropous type of the ohul. The ohul shows the oval shape, soft tissue in the center called the nucellus. Let us see in the figure. Nucellus, protective layer to protect the endosperm. Nucellus is there. The nucellus is covered by the three layered integument, outer thin and fleshy layer sarcotesta and middle sclerotesta. The innermost layer get absorbed by the developing gametophyte. The apical end of nucellus forms a beak like structure to produce the pollen chamber. Let us see in the figure. Pollen chamber is there. The megaspores lies deep in the center of the nucellus, and the functional megaspore divide repeatedly to form the female gametophyte. Okay, in this way, this is the structure of the ohul. They are having the three layered integument is there. Okay, outer, middle and inner layer structure, and in that structure the pollen chamber is there. In pollen chamber the nucellus is there, and in the nucellus the endosperm is there. that endosperm having the egg cells in them. In this way, this is about the structure of ovum. Next one, the structure of seed in the cycas. The mature seed, let us see in the figure. The mature seed consists of the outer red color testa with which is formed from the integument of the ovule. Below this lies in the thin layer of the endosperm, which is formed from the nucellus. The endosperm surrounded the embryo, consisting of radical plumule and two cotyledon and suspensor. Let us see in the figure. Two cotyledons are present there. At the upper side, radical. At the upper side, radical is there, and plumule. Let us see the plumule structure. And two cup scales are surrounded to the radical or the seed coat. Okay, and this cotyledon are surrounded by the seed coat. This is the structure of the seed of the cycas. I hope you are understand that. Thank you. Thank you very much.